Okay. All right, have a good night.
Alternative main campus. Interesting. So, I mean, that does have the implication that there's only one alternative main campus, which is good.
Previously on Life is Strange.
Whoa!
You don't know who the fuck I am or who you're messing around with!
Don't ever touch me again, freak! Let's talk about your superpower.
What are you doing here, Max? Stop! Don't come near me!
Not now. It won't work.
I know this isn't pleasant for any of us. Miss Caulfield, please, tell us everything.
Hey, it's Thelma and Louise.
That's Rachel's bracelet. Why the fuck are you wearing her bracelet?
Calm yourself, all right? It was a gift.
Max, we have to find Rachel soon. Like you said, it's time to start the search for clues.
Welcome to my domain. Let's find what we want and beat it.
Max, you better come check out these files. Rachel in the dark room. Over and over. That's it. Listen. I found pictures of Rachel and Frank. Being more than a friend. I can't believe she was banging Frank. Rachel straight up lied to my face. Why didn't she say anything?
So who do you most want to blame?
My fucking dad, of course. Hello? No, you don't. Do you know what it's like to wait for your father to come home when you're a kid? Ever since he died, my life has been dipped in shit.
Chloe, I am awesome. We are awesome.
Hello? Are you even listening, Maxine?
This is totally fucked up. What else have I changed?
Max Caulfield. Hold on.
Chloe, you have a visitor.
So I guess this means that the offer of books at Powell's is off the table. Oh shit, that was the handicapped fund. But Punk Chloe wasn't there to help me rob it, so it probably won't have any bearing this time. The money that we stole from the principal's office was from the handicapped fund, and I don't know if that money is even going to have been stolen in this timeline, but that'd be pretty ironic if it was, because it's for Chloe.
It's weird hanging out with you again.
I know. I'm glad we are, though.
It was nice that you sent me actual letters. It's more than any of my other friends have done. And you even wrote on that cool parchment paper. It's so Max.
So pretentious. But I love writing on it like an English poet. You deserve the best stationery.
Probably easier to write than to visit me. I don't mean that in a bitchy way. Not totally. You probably wanted to avoid awkward conversations like this.
Pretty much. Yeah.
Look, the worst thing you can do is treat me like a baby. I still want to laugh and talk shit with my best friend. Can we stop? This is seriously the best view of the sunset. What do photographers call that?
The golden hour.
See? Without you here, I'd have no clue. Bet you could take some amazing shots. Those beached whales are so sad. I kind of know how they feel. At least, I'm alive here with you.
You're a real survivor, Chloe. I know you have to deal with so much.
I don't want anybody else feeling sorry for me. I can do that. Along with my parents. My dad still feels guilty about buying me that car.
Are you okay to talk about the accident?
We never actually have, huh? There's not much to say. Some prick in an SUV cut me off and I flew into a ditch.
Do you remember everything?
I saw everything in bullet time. I felt my back snap and that was the last thing I ever felt in my body. When I woke up in the hospital, I literally couldn't move a muscle.
Jesus. I don't know what to say.
Don't say anything. I'm just happy I did get to see you again. I could have ended up vanishing out of the blue like that girl from Blackwell.
What missing girl?
I don't know her name. I just read about it in the news. I feel bad for her family.
This is such a different world than when we were kids, isn't it?
After that snow and eclipse, it's more like the end of the world.
It might be, but I'd like to think we can still change things for the better.
I'd like to think that too, but I don't have much hope these days.
I know things seem out of control, but as long as we're together, I don't feel afraid.
Hanging out with you makes me feel like a total kid again. You don't even know.
Listen, Chloe, I'm sorry I haven't been out to see you more. That was wrong. You're my best friend.
Max, thanks for coming out to see me. You're doing awesome.
I don't think so.
My nose is getting cold. Maybe we should get back to my place?
It is hella cold out here.
Hella? I hate that word, no offense.
None taken.
So Rachel Adams is an independent event from William Joyce, Daniel, Chloe. So whatever went down did happen with Frank, or with Nathan, or any of the other people at the school. At least you know she didn't run away because of Chloe now. Or get killed because of Chloe. Oh, of course her bedroom's downstairs.
It's a pretty high-tech lair.
Feels like a high-tech cell. But I am lucky my parents bust their ass to take care of me. I know it's hard for them.
They're grateful you're here with them.
Right. Especially when they can't even take a walk alone. Sometimes I act like a total teenage brat just to give them an excuse to yell at me. Pathetic, I know.
Chloe, you're a great daughter. You're kind and sensitive, when you don't even have to be.
Trust me, I still get my rage on. Especially when a nurse has to watch while I take a dump so she can wipe my bum. Or when doctors flip me around like I was a science doll.
I can't even imagine. But you're still amazing. You always have been since we were kids.
Thanks again for coming, Max. I need to get my drink on. Can you bring me some water?
Scround. What room is this? This is the garage. Right?
Does Chloe look at the garden and think about her childhood? She can't even feel the grass now. I'm glad I took this photo. Chloe has a new memory of William and her together. At least Chloe doesn't weigh that much. Oh man. She has to use that ventilator just to breathe.
Max, it is so cool that you're here again.
I'm glad you think so. That's a serious heat lamp. Hello, Chloe. She likes fluffy animals now.
Snow globes are still intact.
Oh, the snow dough. I guess not everything changed. Snow globes are taking over. I still can't believe I put Chloe in that chair.
No, you didn't.
It's nice my parents sent a card at least. I wonder who this is. Kind of a generic card.
Megan.
I wasn't very available to Chloe. Real nice. At least I sent road trip selfies to Chloe. I'm sure that made her feel great. Man. Joyce and William built a whole new bathroom for Chloe.
Okay, so that's...
They're so great. I should have kept more in touch. I should offer to put makeup on for Chloe. Not that I can, but it would be fun.
Oh, a mouth stick. Cool.
Whoa, Chloe can totally control her computer. It's so great people get this high-tech help. Chloe is still a punk at heart. She can't stage dive anymore. That's so cool that Chloe has made friends online.
She's stolen the cars.
There's the old Chloe. That must be her mighty morphine machine. No more bongs for her.
Okay, let's get her the water.
Drink up, Buttercup.
Oh man. No wonder my throat is dry. I don't think I've talked this much the whole year.
Have you ever thought about doing a podcast or something?
I wish I could punch your face right now. A podcast? Dude, I am a pod in a cast. Boring.
Ouch. It was just a thought.
I know you're just trying to help.
Yeah, that's become a bad habit of mine.
You sound like an adult now. It seems like we were kids in another life.
What do you remember about us as kids?
we all have different memories.
I think about us as little pirates, running and jumping through Arcadia Bay.
Me too. But we're still pirates in our own way.
Yeah, right. Check me out, Chloe of the Caribbean. No way will I get on a fucking boat now. Unless you're with me. As you can see, I can't keep all my other friends away.
Which friends did you hang out with the most?
Megan Weaver, but you don't know her. She was cool. But after my accident, she was too cool for school.
I know I wasn't around much. No excuses, I'm a loser. But I am trying to make things right.
How? Dude, you're not Supermax. And I'm not trying to guilt trip you. That's what my parents are for.
I know this is a dumb question, but are you lonely here?
Yes, dumb question. I don't mind being alone. I can't exactly go party like a rock star, though. Or get in any teen trouble with the folks.
I think Joyce and William are incredible.
Max, the accident has been so hard on them. Our insurance sucks, and the medical bills are fucking insane.
Can they pay all the bills?
No way. They keep the numbers away from me, but it doesn't take much research to find out I'm costing my parents almost $1 million a year.
Chloe, you're priceless. No pun intended.
You're such a geek. That's why I love you. Of course, I know a geek when I be one. See, I'm practically a human entertainment system. It would be sweet to chill out together and watch a movie like when you'd spend the night at my house.
What do you want to watch?
I think I'm in like a mellow Blade Runner mood. I always cry at the end. Plus, you know I always wanted to have cool colored bangs like Pris.
I know. You would look incredible with blue hair. Now let's get this show on the road. And you better not fall asleep on me like you always do when we watch movies.
I remember, Max. Swear I won't fall asleep. Not when you're here. Not yet.
Text. Oh my god, this is probably gonna be so different. So the window, bird nest, pile of rocks, two dog tails, footprints, a whale's tail, a windmill, skeleton with a skateboard, some sort of bird like. Probably at the Halloween party, the moon. Okay. What the hell? Okay, so now I'm at odds with the Misfits. So she is a stoner now, and she hangs out with the Vortex. She's like best friends with Taylor. The dark room. That might be what's attached to Jefferson's office. So she's like legit friends with Nathan. Wow. Yeah, the dark room, yeah. So whatever went down, if that was next to Jefferson's office, Jefferson might have something to do with Rachel's disappearance. clothes using emoji. Wow. Yeah, Maxine.
Glad to see her as nosy as it.
Despite everything, they're still a happy family again. It's cool that in this reality, Chloe really loves skating too. Wowzer. Chloe was a straight A student. She could have gone to any college.
The fuck else would you do when you're in a wheelchair?
Gutless bastard. I am so glad Chloe stole your bullshit fund. Even if it wasn't another reality.
I see. So she had to stop going to Blackwell because of the building. Recommending her for Miskatonic. Oh my god. It's a fucking Cthulhu school. Oh, that's so funny. Can I talk to you? Okay.
Aha, here's the DVD. Oh my god, I made that mix for her when we were 12.
Second pillage.
Thanks. I think you missed a grain stuck in my eyeball.
Hard to believe how just a little sand can cause such a big mess.
It's like that Chinese proverb, a spark can start a fire that burns the entire prairie. You know, like the butterfly thing.
So I've heard. Nothing but medical supplies. She has to use a lot of lotion to keep her blood circulating.
Is anything lost? Okay. I wonder what William does for a living.
I cannot believe you fell asleep so fast. How dare you? I know you were beat down after the day with me, and Blade Runner is a pretty dreamy movie to watch at night. Do you think Deckard is a replicant? Sorry, I can see you're not wide awake like me.
No, I'm sorry I crashed so hard. Were you okay?
I do have a mother and father when you're not falling asleep on me.
You are a bitch in the morning.
It's the company I keep. Yesterday was such a blast.
It was great. Seeing you.
I know things were different when we were just dorky kids, but Being with you made me feel like when we were little pirates, jumping and running through the forests again. It meant a lot to me just to chill out with you and bullshit. Fuck. I'm getting my regular head pains. Can you pretty please go upstairs and get my morphine injector in the bathroom?
Morphine injector?
It's total Star Trek shit. You can't even see the needle. Seriously, I need it. My parents keep this wag upstairs because they think I can't get to it. But you can, Max. Like a pirate, right?
I'm on it, Chloe. Does Chloe look at the garden and think about her childhood? She can't even feel the grass now.
So it is the garage, okay.
I definitely have to take a third job.
Yeah, where she got the car. Yeah, but I don't know when the accident
They gave
was.
Chloe their giant expensive HDTV, and they use her shitty tube television. Damn. This is just for Chloe's basic supplies.
Wrecked.
Bonjour. That's great they finally went to Paris. To think that our destiny is linked to goddamn car keys.
Oh, great.
These whales are just a preview of the tornado to come. Rachel Amber is even missing in this reality. I guess I can't change everything.
Hey, William. Am I bothering you?
Why, yes, Max. I love going through bills. Kidding. How can you bother me? I haven't seen you in forever.
I know. You look exactly the same. It's so cool.
Good. Or I'd be scared if I didn't look like me. Of course, you seem more adult now. So what's on your mind?
I don't know how to say this, but... I'm truly sorry about what happened to Chloe.
Me too. All it takes is a few minutes to change a girl's whole life. But she's alive. She's been a trooper.
She is amazing. I'm so glad you're here to help her. And be her father.
I'm so glad Joyce is here to help us both. Max, I just hate to think of what would happen to Chloe if I wasn't here.
William, I just want you to know that whatever happens, I'll always be here for Chloe. Always.
I know you will, Max.
So you finally made it to Paris?
Oui, as they say. Not me, because I can't speak French. But it was a great experience, especially for Chloe.
I can see her loving it there. You guys rock for going on a family adventure like that.
She talked about going to school there, but that's not practical anymore. It's not fair, Max.
I was impressed by Chloe's room and all the high-tech equipment.
You should be. We could buy a few mansions for what it all costs. Insurance helps, but I don't know, Max.
I know it must be hard on you guys financially.
These bills are more like crushing. We have to mortgage our home, and that's pretty scary. But we'll get through it. Price is always right. Get it? No?
Being around you and Joyce again is... so... nostalgic.
Very old school, as they say. I think it's great for Chloe to see you. Makes Joyce happy, too. So, it's not all bad news in Arcadia Bay. Or is it?
I was reading about that missing girl. Rachel Amber.
Oh, yes. She went to Blackwell, right? Oh, poor thing. That's a real nightmare for a family. I get scared thinking about Chloe and that we might lose her someday.
What do you think is going on with all of this crazy weather and animals dying?
Nobody knows, right? It is Nostradamus type shit, pardon my French. But all I actually care about now is Chloe and Joyce. My family.
The Prescott family might be bad news. What do you think about them?
Evil. Next question?
Sounds like you know them well.
More than I want to. But Joyce has to work for those greedy bastards at Pan Estates. I don't even like to think about it.
I have to go see if Chloe needs anything. It was so great talking with you again.
You act like it's the last time. And please, keep me from these bills whenever you want.
They might get their own home taken away because of medical bills. That's terrible. No change to spare anymore. Now it's back to cookies. Joyce is a food coupon boss.
This insurance is worthless.
Joyce and William never had a garage sale before. They're drowning in debt just to take care of their daughter. Such bullshit.
Yeah, I wonder what she does for the Prescotts.
It's all about you, Arcadia Bay, isn't it?
Oh, Max, it is so nice to have you around.
Look at them. They have no idea what's in their future. That is such a sweet shot of Chloe. I wonder who took the picture. William is trying so hard. He's still awesome.
I wonder if she can only teleport to pictures she took.
Oh no. I didn't realize how bad Chloe's injury really was.
I guess not photos she's in, but like just photos that, you know, because she took it, she had to have been there. Oh, Chloe might be dying.
Joyce used to hate smokers in the diner. Joyce is already a super mom.
Good morning, Max. You and Chloe are so much quieter now than when you were kids.
I remember. It's nice waking up in your house again.
Oh, William and I love it. Finally seeing you and Chloe together after all these years. After the accident.
I wish I was a better friend. I know Chloe doesn't get many visitors.
Oh, Max, you're Chloe's best friend for a reason. You're here exactly when she needs you.
Who helps Chloe out when you guys are at work?
We have a series of revolving nurses and caretakers. Chloe still causes trouble, even if she can't move. Max, Chloe's condition is not improving. Her respiratory system is very weak, and she... Do you know what I'm saying?
Joyce, I'm so sorry you have to go through all this.
Bad or good, I embrace every moment with my daughter and my husband. This is what it means to be a family, and we'll always be one, no matter what.
How are you doing, Joyce?
I'm doing the best I can, Max. I won't lie, it's difficult, but nobody said life was easy here in Arcadia Bay.
Plus, you guys have to work, too.
Bill and I have no time for ourselves. We're working more than we're living. I even had to take a part-time gig at Pan Estates. Ugh.
Do you know the Prescotts?
I know that Sean Prescott won't be happy until he owns everything in Arcadia Bay. Stay away from his son, Nathan.
Do you know somebody named David Madsen? He, might hang out at the Two Wheels.
Well, that was random. Yeah, he's a bus driver. He comes in sometimes. Cute, quiet. Why?
Oh, I was just curious.
You always were. Nice to see that everything doesn't change.
So, what do you think is going on here with all of this eco-havoc?
Maybe Arcadia Bay just wants to be left alone. I know the feeling. Honestly, I don't give a shit about too much outside our house.
I don't blame you, Joyce.
Except now we have dead birds and beach whales outside our front door. So maybe I should care, for Chloe's sake.
I have to tell you how much I love seeing you and William together again.
He's been such a hero through all this. Chloe and I are lucky to have him.
Chloe and William seem like they still get along so good.
Yeah, those two are closer now more than ever. Chloe will actually listen to William while she usually ignores me. Oh, it's so cute when they gang up on poor old me.
You rule, Joyce.
Shit. Things would be different if I did. I like how you think, kid.
I better get back to Chloe now. It's good talking with you, Joyce.
You too, honey.
Apparently, the only thing that hasn't changed is this view. It's cool that Chloe uses natural medicine, too. Nothing here. The bathroom looks almost the same. Just more medicine. Here it is. I never thought I'd be delivering morphine to my best friend. How's it going, Time Tripper? Funny. I think I look older. I'm sure this is a total coincidence. At least we never had to hide from Stepdouche. I guess we stopped growing up together. I'm still overwhelmed by this new reality.
I want to spoil
so guilty for putting Chloe and her family through this. I could give Chloe the choice of keeping William alive, but that would be cruel. But then I see that they're a family again.
Fix the accident.
Who am I to judge? I never heard much about William's brother.
Spool
shoes. Chloe always did love stomping around in her boots. Toys? I kinda wanna open this and see what's in here. They bought crutches for Chloe. Hoping she might walk again. They bought crutches for Chloe. Hoping she might walk again. Too bad Joyce and William can't get any help from the Prescott Foundation.
Finally. Give me the blue pill.
I'm sorry. I'm nosy, but not precise.
Go ahead and plug it right in. It's so easy. And painless.
Okay, but get ready to yell for your folks if I screw up.
Oh, trust me. I will. Of course, my pain just keeps getting worse. But you caught me on a good day. Max, I'm so grateful that I'm even able to hang out with you. See, I'm getting mushy. I'm already high.
You're so adorable. Do you want anything else?
Stop me if I'm being too emo. But can you grab one of the photo albums over there? I'd like to check out some old pictures of us when we were kids.
Yes.
Please. My diary is like emo ground zero. Plus, Max Caulfield does not pass up a photo op with Chloe Price. Ever. Is that okay?
Perfect. Oh my god, look how little we are there. We look like toys.
I remember that day by the lighthouse.
My dad was pissed at us. He actually tried to give us a timeout.
And you laughed at him. My dad would have banished me.
Whoa, awesome picture. We look so badass in our pirate gear.
We should have taken over Arcadia Bay when we had the chance.
There's still time for you. Oh man, there we are making pancakes. I love that shot of us. It's hard to believe my dad took that picture only 5 years ago.
Literally seems like yesterday.
I wish it was.
Me too. This photo... Maybe I could...
Listen, Max. My respiratory system is failing, and it's only getting worse. I've heard the doctors talking about it when they thought I was zonked out. So, I know I'm just... putting off the inevitable while my parents suffer along, and I will too. This isn't how I want things to end.
What? What are you saying?
I'm saying that being with you again has been so special. I just wanted to feel like when we were kids running around Arcadia Bay and everything was possible, and you made me feel that way today. I want this time with you to be my last memory. Do you understand?
Yes, I do.
All you have to do is crank up the IV to 11. I'll just drift to sleep, dreaming of us here together, forever. Thank you so much. I'm so proud of you for following your dreams. Don't forget about me.
Never.
I love you, Max. See you around.
Sooner than you think.
So I got the whole photo album to mess with now. Machines better not have an alarm. Yep, photo time.
I'm sorry, William.
Someday Dad'll get one of them newfangled computers.
I hope the flash didn't scare you, Max. This is a keeper. Hello? Hey, honey. What? Oh, I didn't know you had to get groceries. Of course I'll come pick you up. Shit, where are my keys?
That's a dollar for the swear jar.
You mean your college fund. Jeez.
Burn it, you'll have no way back.
Aha! You can't hide from me forever. And no Chloe and Max wine tasting session.
Dad!
Don't blow it, because tonight your mother promised to make us a world-famous salmon surprise with chocolate cake for dessert. Max, you'll be here too, right?
She's never leaving me.
That makes all of us.
Max, you are being so fucking strange. Like you're never gonna see us again.
Chloe, I'm so sorry. I tried to make things different for you. I did try. I'm sorry.
I don't know exactly what you're talking about, but come on. You have made things different, like my whole life. You're my best friend. I've got you and a great family. What's to be sorry for? We'll be best friends forever. And when we grow up, we're taking over the world.
Listen, whatever happens, I want you to be strong. Even if you feel like I wasn't there for you. Because I will never abandon you, Chloe. I'll always have your back. Always.
Thank you. Okay, back to where we left off. They moved the art upstairs. That's what that picture was. Oh shit, is this her Hiro Nakamura time wall?
Chloe, you're alive. Yes.
Whoa, down, Max. You get one kiss, now you're all over me?
I'm so glad you're here.
You sound high, but thanks for the morning grope. Since we were up all night playing CSI Arcadia Bay, I was still spaced out here trying to put all this info together.
I get a time wall.
Max, did you forget we've gone over this? I hope you weren't messing around with time while I was sleeping.
Time passes.
Not anymore. I'm just spaced out too. Welcome back to the real world, Max. Let's look at the big board and see all our pieces in the puzzle so far. So close, yet so far away. We have to do three main things.
Right. What things?
One, decipher Frank's logbook. Two, get Nathan's phone to find out where he's been during the Vortex Club parties with Kate and Rachel. And see whatever hidden shit he's got in his messages.
Three, beat Stepdouche Dan until he tells us about Frank, Nathan, and the Dark Room. And I do have a gun now.
Keep it in your pants. We'll have to do this on our own.
Dude, at least let me kick his ass, then rewind. Fine, whatevs. It's our power.
Which I can't waste on shit like that. Or Blackwell would be in big trouble.
At least you let me take that money to pay Frank off.
Don't remind me. I just want him off your back. Our back.
I know. You should get busy in the garage to see what dirt you can dig up. I'm gonna cyberstalk some names and see where that leads. Or to who. And be careful of Stepcrack. Unless you want to hang out with him after you stood up for his ass yesterday.
Oh, please.
The best way.
I can't abuse this level of my rewind power. It's way too dangerous, and I need to navigate the present without messing up the past.
Right. Don't butterfly effect this shit.
There's Chloe's cash stash. Sorry, Principal Wells. Things that aren't really happening. I'm so sorry, William. It's not fair you had to die twice. I should have known just erasing that phone message wouldn't stop the police. This butterfly photo seems like a million years ago. How much time have I altered since? I still feel sketchy about giving Chloe the gun back. That snow dough always makes me think of William and Chloe. It's amazing how innocent our drawings were compared to what we're doing now. That's my Chloe. This is a serious expose on the Prescotts. Finally. Even Holmes and Watson didn't use every piece of information. Staying up all night is the best excuse to drink lots of coffee.
Amen, sister.
Yes, Chloe Price was here. Oh no, That poor little bird has been trapped in here.
Can I open a window for it? Honestly, though, birds are dying outside. Is this the best thing?
Fly, be free.
Metaphor bird.
Oh, that blue dye makes me so happy. It means the real Chloe is back with me.
Yo, what up?
Since David might be in there, I better mosey along for a change. Yep, locked from the other side.
Warren. What the hell? Okay. Okay, you got the B minus because I didn't edit his test. Oh, that's so hilarious. Chloe was responding to the text. Chloe texted him, for real. Oh shit, the pins are being set in motion. Friend zoned. Sorry, dude, but you're useless in a fight against Nathan Prescott.
Those poor whales are like beached angels. What is going on here? Looks like they're back on the road to Paris. Joyce really wants David and Chloe to be a family.
Press A to monologue.
Somehow, I existed in this whole other reality. But I don't know what happened. The more I use my power, the more I see how little control I have over what happens. Now, Max Caulfield exists in two, or maybe three different realities. How can I have a destiny? These alternate lives exist. I hate the thought of William and Joyce finding Chloe like that. Thinking about all these lifelines almost makes my head hurt worse than the rewind. I think this all started with my vision of a tornado.
Shit, it's David. I'll talk to him a bit. Try to bury the hatchet. Are there any things to take a picture of? Like a bird's nest? No? That was fucking productive. Wait, what?
William never finished painting that wall. David even made sure to bag up the dead birds. Looks like David finished his car repairs. Maybe there's some new clues around. I wonder if David is going to the party.
Sorry, but this is my official man cave, so no girls allowed.
Whoa, that is a serious padlock on that locker. Hey David, what you hiding?
That was a combination though. It was like 7171 or something like that. Yeah, wow, my
yes.
Memory is falling.
I knew that number would be important. Notes, coordinates, photos of Kate, Nathan. Oh, yes.
Twin Peaks. That is Chloe's license plate number, isn't it? Is it a GPS tracker? Some motherfucking GPS. Is he building a case against Nathan?
Score. Back to Chloe now. Surveillance cameras at Pan Estates? David must be working for the Prescotts, too. Should I have signed the petition? Blackwell sure isn't safe and private anymore. Since the locker's already open, I don't need that key.
Hey, Missy, you do know I can see you snooping around.
Oh, that makes me sad. It was so incredible to see William again. I wish Chloe could too. What the hell did David do for Nathan? And what did his dad do for David?
Anything I can do for you, Max?
I was just waiting for Chloe to get out of the bathroom so we can go.
I owe you one. So I'll pretend what you just said is true, Missy.
Excuse me, that's Miss Caulfield.
Yes, sir. You and Chloe still better be careful where you wander. There are a lot of dark places in Arcadia Bay.
What do you mean by dark places?
I can't tell you everything that's going on at Blackwell. And you've seen too much already, so please stay out of this, Max.
Too late. I already know way too much. Like the fact that you might be working for Sean Prescott.
What? Who told you that? Nathan Prescott? That little shit-ass is lucky he didn't get suspended.
Yeah, I was lucky to only get suspended. Thanks to you.
I didn't have all the evidence at the time. I am sorry, Max. So, are you gonna tell me why you think I'm working for Sean Prescott?
I saw documents that you were hired to do surveillance and security at Pan Estates.
God damn. You are a good detective. But I didn't get hired. I gave Sean Prescott an estimate. For my own reasons. Anyway, I think we can both agree it's been a hard week on all of us. Especially poor Kate Marsh.
I tried to help Kate.
You did, Max. You saved her life like a hero while I left the goddamn dorm roof wide open. I knew Kate was feeling desperate. You even made it to the roof before me or anybody.
I knew Kate was desperate too. So did Mr. Jefferson.
That guy is an elitist prick. I'm off duty, so I can say it at home behind his back. Like when Chloe calls me step douche. These artists live in a fantasy world.
Why do you say that?
These art farts are all about themselves. When I was in the service, I hated the photographers who tried to pose me in their anti-war bullshit.
Well, Blackwell Academy is a school for artists, so maybe this isn't the best place for you.
I have a family here, Max, and I think Blackwell is the best place for me, since only I know what's happening. Of course, thanks to Mrs. Grant and her hippie anti-surveillance petition, I hope everybody feels safer, like Rachel Amber and Kate Marsh. Although, you're like a walking surveillance system. I appreciate you standing up for me, but I have to be a hard ass and tell you and Chloe to stay the hell out of this. Things are just gonna get more ugly.
Chloe and I can take care of ourselves.
Now excuse me, Max. I have to get back to my camera. See? I'm an artist too. Max, I don't totally trust
David, but he's not a real step-führer. Maybe Chloe will see that someday. The most expensive restaurant in town? David knows how to get on Joyce's good side.
Yo, Chloe! Are you ready yet? I have to get back to my dorm.
Are we happy?
Very happy. I hit the secret file jackpot. It's Kate, Nathan, and Rachel. Plus there's some location coordinates. David is like a one-man surveillance army. Now let's get the hell out of here before we get busted.
But I absolutely have to go see Kate in the hospital right now. I want to find out how she's doing. This is definitely Kate's floor.
The hospitals always freak me out.
I hear you. But imagine how Kate feels. I'm so glad I get to see her again. I hope it's not too weird for her.
No, she'll be stoked to see you. Who wouldn't be?
This be it. I'm a little nervous.
Just go in there and be her friend. I'll wait out here so you can chill by yourselves. I was a total dick for blowing a fuse when you answered Kate's call the other day.
Thank you.
Good thing you ignored me. I had no idea what shit she was going through. And you saved her. Like me. I'm sorry.
Thanks, Chloe. But don't be sorry. We're all on the same team.
Team Max. Let Kate know we're gonna string Nathan up by his balls then.
Oh yes. I'm on it.
Max!
Oh, Kate.
I thought I'd never see you again. I feel so ridiculous. I'm so sorry.
Kate. Listen to me. You have nothing to be sorry about. Other people do. You do not know how happy I am to see you. You look awesome. Is it a stupid question if I ask how you're doing?
Now that you're here, I'm doing even better. I'm so grateful to you for coming up to the roof to talk me down. Max, I felt so lost and alone. When I saw how much you cared, how hard you were trying, you made me realize I wasn't alone. Thank you.
Kate, there are so many people who love you and want to help you.
I know. You should see all the letters and postcards.
I gave most of the flowers to other patients here because they need them more than me. I'm keeping the balloons, though. One of the nurses gave me some pen and paper so I could do some drawings.
I love your illustrations.
They got kind of dark there for a while, but I have an idea for a new children's book about bullying. I was thinking of having some photographs in there, too.
I hope that's a subtle hint that you'll let me take the photographs for the book.
Was that subtle? You better take the pictures, Max. I'm going to be here for another day until my family comes out to visit.
How are they treating you?
Like they need to protect me forever. They're so upset, and I know they feel guilty even though they didn't do anything. I was surprised how many students from Blackwell wrote me. Daniel, Mr. Jefferson, even Victoria wrote me a very sweet note. And I believe she was being real.
Me too. I'm glad you believe again, Kate.
I'm working on it, Max. I just pray I can get this drawing right.
That is so sweet. Even Victoria signed. But not Nathan. Victoria Chase might be Queen Bitch, but she's not evil. Principal Wells knows how to step it up when he wants to. Thank you, sisters. You really saved Kate. Good to see that Kate is still working on her book report. Oh, I love Kate's happy rainbow flock. I don't think get well is quite apropos. If this gets Kate through the night, so be it. Those are nice flowers. And from Taylor? Wow, props to her. Kate, it is so good to hang out with you again.
Max, I owe you so much. And I can tell you want to talk to me about something.
I saw Victoria's letter. How does that make you feel?
Max, I know Victoria can be not nice, but I do believe in forgiveness and redemption. I might be naive, but I feel her struggle.
I wasn't so nice to her this week either, when I took a picture of her covered in paint. Not a proud moment.
We all have our moments. Why do you think she acts so mean?
She's insecure. If you're comfortable with yourself, you don't need to act superior.
Victoria doesn't look like she has much to be insecure about.
If anybody could make Victoria see the light, it would be Kate Marsh.
No. I think it will take more than that, Max.
I want you to know I'm this close to getting all the info I need about Nathan.
Nathan Prescott has to pay for what he did. And we have to stop him from hurting anybody else.
I wish I could have gotten his ass kicked out of Blackwell.
Me too. But his dad would never let that happen. I thought I had a tough family. So what is going on with him now?
I assume he'll show up at the Vortex Club party tonight like nothing happened.
And nobody can do anything to him after what he did.
We're going to stop him. I just have to find Nathan's room number, get inside, and get the clues I need.
Max, please let me help. I can get the number, and I'll text it to you, okay?
Of course, Kate. I can't do this without you.
Now it's time for Nathan to watch out for us.
I always want to talk to you.
We missed our tea session this week.
That was so not cool. We need to plan, like, a tea shop tour of Portland.
Oh, yes. And you could bring Warren along, too.
No boys allowed.
You are funny, Max. And right.
I have to get back to our mission. You don't know how much it means to see you again.
I do. That's why I love you, Max. Thanks for taking care of my bunny. Tell Alice I'll see her soon.
Alice. Okay, a tea shop tour. I still like Max's idea of books and towels, though.
Well, how is she?
She's still Kate Marsh. Thank God.
I'm glad we came to see her.
Thanks for coming with me.
Now let's go pay a visit to Nathan Prescott. That little prick is not going to be glad when he sees us.
That's a cool color.
Hey, Max. How you doing?
Oh, hi, Mr. Jefferson. I'm okay. And this is my friend, Chloe.
Yeah.
Chloe? Why isn't somebody as cool as you going to Blackwell?
I was way too cool for this school. It's a long story. In actual files here.
I can imagine. Max, are you sure that you're all right?
It's weird being suspended and just walking around campus.
Well, you are an adult now. This isn't prison, is it?
Not until we get orange jumpsuits.
On that note, Blackwell duty calls. Remember, I'm going to announce the winner of the Everyday Heroes contest tonight at the party, so I hope you'll be there to celebrate, even though I'm sorry you didn't enter a photo. I understand your reasons. You can't force an artist to work.
I feel like a total loser, but it's been a hard week to focus. No pun intended.
I'm proud of you for caring so much about a troubled friend, and I take hope in the fact that you have plenty of time to find your way. Just get in the habit of putting your work out there.
Thanks, Mr. Jefferson. I'll definitely be there tonight.
Me too. I'll be Max's date. You better dance with us at least once.
Nobody should have to see me dance. Plus, you don't want to watch the old hipster trying to keep up with the kids. I have some pride. Be seeing you.
Yes, you will. Hot for teacher.
Rose! You're out of control.
Not yet. Just wait until the rager tonight.
Shut up.
Don't be jealous because Mark Jefferson thinks I'm cool.
I am so ignoring you.
Fine. Since I'm here, I'll see if I can get some dirt from Justin. I haven't talked to him in a while.
Now that is a great plan.
If Jefferson knew Rachel, he'd know Chloe.
Let's see if I can find out where Nathan is. Principal Wells was so loaded the other night here.
I had to save Alyssa from something today.
Hey, Daniel. You look bummed out. Are you alright?
Hola, Max. I just figured out that my photos basically suck. I'm a wannabe artist.
Oh my god, he has a fedora tipping shirt. M'lady.
You're not here to be a photographer. That's my gig. Look at that sketch you did of me. Incredible. And that's your art. Your gift.
I do feel better now. You are good, Max.
By the way, have you seen Nathan Prescott?
You mean lately?
Like, anytime today?
I saw Jefferson talking with Nathan a little while ago, but I try to stay out of his way. I have enough assholes to deal with here.
Have you talked to anybody about what happened with Kate?
Don't talk to anyone, Max. But I did actually have a nice talk with Brooke. She couldn't stop talking about how brave you were on that roof.
I don't think doing the right thing is brave, but I appreciate what she means. The most important thing is that Kate gets better and gets justice.
I hear that, Max. She's the sweetest, most genuine person I've ever met. I don't mind getting picked on by Blackwell broholes, but don't fuck with Kate.
I like this revolutionary Daniel DaCosta.
Only if I can start the revolution from my sketchbook, Max.
Are you going to the end of the world party tonight?
It will be if I go, man. People here push me into lockers, not dance floors.
That's exactly why you should go to that party. We have to stand up to these Blackwell bullies for Kate. You won't be alone, Daniel.
Can I get all the
Not with you to back me up, Max. Oh, damn it. I will go to the party like it is the end of the world. Okay, maybe I won't go, but... No, I won't do that, but I'll go.
Let's talk later. Okay, Daniel? That's what I get for helping Alyssa. A broken window.
Justin, it's been so long since I've seen you.
Because you're way too cool for us now, Chloe.
Way too much. So I hear.
Any word at all on Rachel?
Dude, I wish. Chloe fits in so easy with Justin.
I miss her laugh.
I can tell that Justin is really into Chloe.
She's probably high.
Yeah.
Enjoy the big game, Zachary. I hope it's not the last.
Shut up. Shut up. Shut up. How's that dream doing? Is the drone gonna like to land on top of it or something? Oh, I just had to get closer.
One photo. For posterity.
Over. I want to see my bunny. Threats to dad. Okay. One get out of emoji tail free card. And that was no emoji. Hey, do I need to talk to the
guy again? Okay, I have to bounce.
Come hang with us at the park.
Thought I'd bug you again, Daniel.
No. Okay.
Fortunately, Max, I like bugs.
Let's talk later.
Anything else to mess with around here? There's a frisbee up there.
I hope Max isn't pissed that Warren asked me to the drive-in.
Not really.
Hey, Brooke. How are you?
I'm here as usual. By the way, Thanks for helping Kate down. Are you okay?
I might feel better taking your drone for a quick flight.
Miss Grant caved and let me fly her again. So take a spin. I have to see what time I'm going to the drive-in with Warren on Saturday.
That sounds fun. It would be good for you and Warren to take a road trip after this week.
Warren got a new car, or an old new car. So I'm all about a serious road trip out of here after this week.
Oh, holy shit.
Thanks.
I hope Max isn't pissed that Warren asked me to the drive-in.
Back again, Brooke.
Are you sure you're all right?
I need to find Nathan. Have you seen him around?
I was distracted by Warren asking me out to the drive-in.
It's a school day, so Nathan should be around.
I did see him this morning heading off campus. He looked more angry than usual. I wouldn't look for him now if I were you.
I hope Max isn't pissed that Warren asked me to the drive-in. I have to go. Talk later, Brooke. Good. Nathan is
back again, Brooke. Are you sure you're...
I have to go.
I hope Max isn't pissed that Warren asked me to the drive-in.
Jesus Christ.
I had to clear away another batch of dead birds today. Sad.
Makes me mad.
How are you doing, Max? Been a tough week. I know.
Yes, it has, Samuel. How are you?
Sad and confused, like everybody else in Arcadia Bay. You look like you have a lot of questions, too.
I still have a million questions about what's happening to Arcadia Bay.
That must be why Miss Gant says you're one of her favorite students at Blackwell.
I keep thinking that Rachel Amber has a few answers, if we can find her.
If Rachel wants to be found.
That's the real secret. Where is she?
If anybody knows, it will be you. My dreams tell me that.
But...
Max, all I can tell you is to stay on your path and you'll find what you're looking for. Rachel Amber is waiting, too.
I'd rather be in her class than the Vortex Club.
Yes, you would. Rachel saw right through them.
She's not the only one.
Nobody should be trapped in the Vortex Club. Get out now, Max, while time is on your side.
More questions than answers.
Samuel is always here to talk.
Have you seen Nathan Prescott around?
I try not to.
Whoa. You really don't like Nathan. How come?
Samuel likes everybody. Until they give him a reason not to. He did.
Well, okay. Enough said. You know a lot of Blackwell secrets, so I thought you could help me.
Max, I'm a custodian, not a psychic. I can only help by warning you to be careful.
I actually just talked to Kate Marsh in the hospital. She's doing so much better.
Because of you, Max. That was quite a rescue.
It could have gone either way. Samuel, do you think that we each have a destiny?
Yes, I do, Max. In many different lifetimes, of course. Kate Marsh believed in something different, so that's her destiny.
I believe you.
Kate just needed some more helpful spirits like her friend Max. I hope she finds them now.
Do you ever talk with David Madsen?
He talks to me. I listen.
That's how David operates.
He sees things, not people. But I think he sees you, Max.
Why do you say that?
Because you both see with cameras.
I think you have better vision than both of us.
No, Max. I just look at everything from a different angle.
I'm sorry. I better get going now.
Ninjas and reel my ass.
Hi, Miss Grant.
Max, you always show up when I'm talking about you. I'm still bragging about you and the other students making Blackwell surveillance free.
I was hoping you could explain some of these crazy things happening in Arcadia Bay.
If I could, I'd be collecting my Nobel Prize in Science today. I haven't been able to wrap my mind around that eclipse, much less the snow in Wales.
I think this is beyond science.
Nothing is beyond science except for our lack of knowledge. We may never know why, but that doesn't change reality.
I am worried about reality. I feel like it's changing right in front of us.
You and Samuel both. We were talking about that before you came over. Our planet is changing, but it's not mystic. It's erosion.
So, you don't think this could be some kind of prophecy or something?
Max, you know how fascinated I am by Arcadia Bay legends. But I haven't found any apocalyptic signs yet. Unless you count those end-of-the-world posters. Unless you know something I don't.
What about wormholes and chaos theory? Like time travel stuff.
The only wormholes in Arcadia Bay are underground. And chaos theory is just that. But if this is about time travel, sign me up.
Would you really change time?
Not after reading that Bradbury story, A Sound of Thunder. I won't give it away, but it involves dinosaurs and butterflies. Time is like a thread, Max. One tug and it all can unravel.
I was looking for Nathan Prescott, and I thought he might be in your class.
I'm surprised, Max. I didn't think you and Nathan were exactly friends.
No way. I just have to, ask him a question.
I saw him leaving campus looking angrier than usual. But to be honest, Max, Nathan hasn't been too well lately. You might know more about that than me.
Too much.
I can tell. You look like you have more than a question on your mind. Maybe asking Nathan isn't such a good idea right now. You hear me, Max?
I don't think surveillance would have helped Kate Marsh.
Who needs surveillance when we have Maxine Caulfield? You did a wonderful thing. And now we have to make sure Kate gets the help she needs. Do you need to talk to a counselor?
Blackwell Academy needs the help. There's something terrible going on here. You see it, right?
This week hasn't been Blackwell's finest hour. But me and some faculty members won't rest until all the students here feel safe, not bullied.
Kate was drugged at the Vortex Club party and bullied by them until she ended up on the roof. How do you stop that?
Shut down that damn Vortex Club for a start. I don't mean to get riled up, but that party should have been postponed. It's extremely tasteless given what happened with Kate.
Do the Prescotts have anything to do with the Vortex Club? I mean, they don't get all their money from car washes.
No, they don't. But membership has its privileges. Especially when your father is Blackwell's biggest sponsor. This elitist nonsense has no place here.
You're right. I just wish this could be the school that I dreamed about before I came here.
I hear you, Max. I love seeing you and Warren and all my students at your best here. But you're all too young to be so cynical. But you truly give me hope.
I'm sorry, Miss Grant. I have to get going. I'll see you later.
It's always good talking to you, Max.
I think everything is changing.
As a scientist, I'm fast.
Oh, great. Chloe stole money from the Handicap Access Fund. We're going to hell. Coast is clear. It would be so cool if you and me were going to school here together.
But now you can have Mr. Jefferson all to yourself.
Ugh, you suck. Now let's get into Blackwell ninja mode.
So lame, they don't have co-ed dorms here.
Yes, because I want Nathan Prescott in the room next door.
Good point.
Wait here. Give me the signal if Nathan or anybody shows up.
I won't let you down, Batmax.
Now I just have to find Nathan's room.
Map? Of course the map is all fucked up.
Who needs a dorm map anyway? At least I can see that Nathan isn't in room 106 or 108. Kate brings it. So, room 111 is the magic number. Evan. Of course. That's why no shits were given. Evan rolls. Apparently, Logan missed this poster.
Julia?
Oh, why, hello, Trevor. And Dana.
That's Dana, okay.
Are toilet paper wars mandatory in the dorms? Every photographer should have one blurry Bigfoot shot. Even after Kate, nobody here learned anything about bullying. Ugh, jerks. At least nobody messed with the Kate portrait. Zach or Logan? Who knows? Bro's got a bro.
Warren's room.
Ugh, skunk weed and video games. I sense Hayden is near. This just makes me think of Kate. Poor Warren. This is the work of Nathan. He's so lucky I'm a pacifist. Hello, Warren's room. Hawking and him make a good team. Looks like one of the jocks did care about Kate. Max, hurry up and find Nathan's room. This can only be Nathan's room.
Now I need to find Nathan's phone, or anything with clues. Nathan clearly has his fetish down. That is so Chloe. Oh my God. Chloe. Whale songs? Maybe this is the only soothing thing Nathan ever hears. That must be the lamp Chloe broke when Nathan drugged her. That looks like a totally fun show. Even Nathan has a light side. Yes, I would be cool with having this high-tech projector. I don't think one book can guide the Prescotts. Damn, Nathan. That's a nice shot. If only all your energy went into photography. It's so damn creepy, but the guy has his own style.
Is that David?
That's so cute and ironic. I can't believe Nathan still has it around. I thought Victoria had the photo bling, but once again, the Prescott's rule. Matt, that monochrome camera is brand new and cost about $6,000. Bastard. I don't think this prescription has helped, Nathan. These films all have a dark pattern. Nathan likes his tortured subjects way too much. Holy shit! That's the gun Nathan used on Chloe.
What about the projector?
A gift from... Holy shit. That's the gun Nathan used on Chloe. A gift from... Come on, Max. You're in the belly of the beast. Search everywhere.
It's not letting me interact more with the projector, unfortunately.
I'd cry too if I had him for a father and had to wear that suit. Let's see what Nathan hides in here.
Oh, I see the computer's controlling the projector.
Nathan is way into this party. Bad sign. Bastard. Now I remember why I hate you. And why Kate will get justice. Sean Prescott might be Nathan's real problem.
To their destiny.
Too bad Nathan isn't more like his sister. She sounds awesome. And far away.
So the dad is my final villain?
Yes, Nathan sure needs diet pills. This is strong stuff.
Is that what he's cutting the drugs with? I know Chloe was talking about that.
Nathan is way into this party. Bad sign.
Jack is stuck now.
What the hell are all those marks on the floor?
Something behind the couch.
Let's find out what you're hiding. Oh yes, little phone. You are mine now.
Secret phone.
Now I have Nathan's phone, so I can show it to Chloe. Well, before Nathan comes back.
It's like Warren gonna be here or some shit.
Damn, Max, you're finally back. I got worried. So, what did you find?
His room was clean and creepy. Check this out.
Boom, Nathan. We got you by the balls, fucker.
What are you doing in my dorm? You're such a nosy bitch, Max!
Stop right there, Nathan!
Make me, ho! Max! I got this!
Get the fuck out of my face!
You are so fucking dead! Get off me, bro!
Guys, rewind.
You like to hurt people, huh? Like Max? Like Kate? Like me? Huh? Feel this, motherfucker! Get off me! Please! Please stop!
He's down! Hey, come on!
Take his gun.
Stop! Sorry.
Yes, we have to go!
Who's the bitch now?
Chloe!
Damn, Warren went full alpha on Nathan. And it was good. But scary.
Shit, man. This really hurts.
I'm wondering.
I think my face is broken.
I want to see what happens. Can I rewind?
Warren, stop it! Come on!
Oh, my head! Why are y'all looking at me like that, huh? You! And you! You're all dead!
Let's go! Now!
Plus, my dad is on his way! You're all fucked! He owns you!
Is there a reason not to get the shit out of him?
Even if Nathan definitely deserved a beating, we should try to be better than that.
No, fuck him up.
Thank you.
his gun. That means you have two.
Damn, Max, you're finally back.
That was intense. Warren, thank you so much.
For what?
For beating the shit out of Nathan Prescott? Dude, you rule.
I don't know. I kind of went crazy there. Like Nathan.
You're not anything like him.
Good to know. So where are you going? I better stick with you guys. Just in case you need me to get my Hulk on again. Or should I call the cops on Nathan?
No police. Not yet. So maybe you better,
Warren, me and Max have to do this on our own. No offense.
It's cool. Whatever I can do to help.
What you can do is find out anything you can about Nathan's father.
I'm on it. Between the snow and eclipse, I'm assuming the apocalypse is around the corner.
And thank you. Seriously. I'll call you later.
You better. I'm feeling pretty alpha now.
Yes, you are.
Man, that guy is so fucking in love with you.
I know.
He really did give a serious beatdown to Nathan.
It was a little scary to watch him do that.
Now let's make a date with Frank.
Will he even answer you?
Frank always answers when he wants money. Like I said, Frank wants to see me right now.
Let's not keep him waiting.
I have two guns. He has no gun. Frank doesn't have a gun, and Nathan doesn't have a gun now. Got the keys to his RV somehow.
I hate seeing those poor whales like that.
Me too. I just think of their families in the ocean out there looking for them. Well, that asshole's gonna help us find Rachel.
Or what? You'll actually shoot him? Chloe, do not count on my rewind. Seriously.
Obviously I'm not counting on you. That's why I have a gun. And I might even save you someday.
About time.
I am so going to hit you. There's no way we could have guessed this is what would happen to us when we grew up.
I'm looking forward to the day when we can just go on a road trip to Portland.
Fuck yeah. You, me, and Rachel.
Absolutely. So let's play this cool, okay? Just pay Frank his money, and then we can get that code for the book from him. That's all.
Got it. No dicking around.
Let's roll.
The forest seemed quiet. No sign of life.
Nope, I don't want to go there.
Need to take a picture of the whales.
There might not be any Pan Estates by Saturday. This is where my nightmare started. I may not know quantum speak, but there has to be an explanation.
Whales.
It blows my mind that I was just here with Chloe in an alternate reality.
I don't think Frank listened to my cleaning advice. It's not funny anyway.
Is there anything else I need?
Good thing there are no actual cops around to bust us. This is where Frank ponders his existence and gets drunk. Take the trash out sometime, dude. Behold, Frank's beer garden.
Oh, look. The Wonder Twins. You should have come alone.
She's my partner.
Yeah, we're bodyguard. So let's get to business. Where's my fucking money?
Why keep the money?
Oh, I thank you. That wasn't so hard now, was it? And let's not do any more business again. Now, if you excuse me.
Frank? Could we ask you a couple quick questions?
You have some serious lady balls. No. Jesus, okay. Okay. But I'm not getting you high.
Frank, we're not here to get high.
No, you don't look like the type. Not like Chloe here. So what do you hardy boys want?
Just the names of some of your clients.
Oh, is that all? Oh, well, why didn't you just tell me? How about I just give you the keys to my RV while I'm at it?
You already did.
Ah, you fucking mental. I lost my keys, but I changed the lock. You better goddamn not be snooping around here.
No, no, I'm not. I...
Oh, Christ, I hate you, Blackwell shits. You expect everything for free. You're not getting any handouts from me. I work for a living, you understand?
Yes, Frank. Without those Blackwell shits as customers, you wouldn't have any work at all. Dude, you're a drug dealer.
Yeah, right, okay. Both of you are giving me a headache. No deal.
Frank, we didn't come here to fight. This is so much bigger than us.
Oh yeah, you didn't come here to fight. A day after, you pulled a fucking gun on me.
I am so sorry about that. It might be the dumbest thing I've ever done. And I've done a lot of dumb things this week.
Finally, I believe you. But don't ever aim a gun at anybody unless you intend to kill. Although you don't look like you could kill a bug.
I try not to. And I never would have pulled the trigger. I was just...
Dude, she was scared, all right? You pulled your blade on me. We were all freaked out. Now we're all cool. Please?
Okay. We're cool for now. But my dog isn't. And if you try any shit, he will bite your head off. He's done it before.
We're only here to talk. I wouldn't mess with your dog.
Shit, you wouldn't have time. You like dogs?
Pompadour.
Oh, Pompadour is so cute.
The only way you know my dog's name is if you broke into my RV. That's how we got out. You did it, are you crazy? That's my dog!
Wait, that's not what...
Seriously, Frank, don't get all spun out. We're only here to find Rachel.
Rachel isn't in here! And I'll spin you on your ass! What the fuck are you dorks up to, huh? Trying to break into my business? This time, the price is wrong, skank!
Calm down, Frank. Let's just talk.
Don't you ever tell me what to do. Get it, bitch? Get it?
Step the fuck back now!
Pompadour! You fucking killed my dog!
Oh my god!
Oh no! Chloe.
I just shot a man and his dog. I killed Frank Bowers.
You saved my life, Chloe. It was self-defense for both of us.
Max? Frank is really dead.
I know, but we can't stop now. We have to find that code. Fast.
Before the cops come.
That's it. Let's get out of here.
Sorry, Frank. I'm sorry.
Ending this peaceably is like the Kate problem.
Listen, Chloe, I can tell you for a fact that this will not go well.
Max, I should have known you would be kind and rewind. So tell me exactly what I need to do here.
You won't like this, but you need to get rid of that gun.
No, Max, I don't like that at all. But I trust you. And girl, if I need that gun, you better rewind fast.
Frank, your dog is kind of scary. Could you please close the RV door?
You aim your gun at me, but you're scared of my dog? That figures. Okay, there, you're safe. Now what do you want?
Just the names of some of your clients.
Oh, is that all?
Listen, Frank, I'm sorry to be such a nuisance, but this is important.
Yeah, everything's important these days. But I can tell you're not bullshitting me.
There's no time for that, Frank. I just need a little bit of information.
Yeah, well, it always starts with just a little. And Chloe here knows all about that, don't you?
Come on, Frank, this isn't about me now.
Yeah, right, okay. Both of you are giving me a headache.
Frank... We didn't come here to fight.
Oh yeah, you didn't come here to fight.
I am so sorry. But
finally, I believe you.
I try not to.
Dude, she was scared all-
We're cool for now.
We're only here to talk.
Shit, you wouldn't have time. You like dogs?
I love dogs. Period. I wish I had one trained as well as yours.
Yeah, he had a bad trainer before. Real bad. But he's dead now. And I trained Pompadour how to be my friend.
That's very cool, Frank. Your dog is lucky you came along.
Maybe we can focus on rescuing Rachel now?
Rachel? Is that why you're really here?
Yes. We're so close to finding her now, Frank. We need all the help we can get now. Especially from you.
You and Chloe do not know Rachel like I did, and I couldn't even help her. You're in way over your heads. Why don't you just go play in your clubhouse?
You have Rachel's bracelet. You obviously know more than you're telling. So tell us.
Never come into my home and tell me what to do. Understand? Man, there is something about you that is so wrong. I don't trust you at all. Now get out of my face.
We don't have much time, Frank.
Rachel needs you.
It's too late! She's gone! You don't even know her!
Like you did? I loved her, asshole! And she loved me. I know that.
Chloe, you don't know shit! You were part of her problem! Always trying to take her away from me! Always!
Calm down, Frank. Let's just talk.
Don't you ever tell me what to do! Get it, bitch! Get it?!
How do you like my blade, kid? Huh?
Whoa! Chloe!
Get off of me!
Motherfucker!
You're both fucking crazy! What do you want?
We just want the code for your account book.
There. Now leave me alone, alright? Just get out of my life.
Do you want us to call an ambulance, or...
No, thanks. You know what? I'll manage somehow without the police.
Oh, right.
Let's bounce.
Shit. This could have gone way worse, but... Frank might be more dangerous to Chloe now. Yes, Max, you can change all this if you want. Listen, Chloe. I can tell you for a fact that this will not go well.
Max, I should have known you would be kind and rewind.
Please watch your mouth. You have no social skills here, and you will piss off Frank immediately.
You kind of love this, don't you? Fine, I'll try being like you for a change. Or how you used to be.
Frank, your dog is kind of scary.
You aim your gun at me, but you're scared of my dog? There, you're safe.
Just the names of some of your clients.
Oh, is that all?
Listen, Frank.
Yeah, everything's important, Dee.
There's no time for that, Frank.
Yeah, well...
Come on, Frank. This isn't about me now.
Yeah, right. Okay. Both of you are giving me a headache.
Frank, we didn't come here to fight.
Oh, yeah. You didn't come here to fight.
I am so sorry. I try not to.
Dude, she was scared already.
We're cool for now.
We're only here to talk.
Shit, you...
I love dogs.
Yeah, he had a bad trainer before.
That's very cool, Frank.
Maybe we can focus on rescuing Rachel now?
Rachel?
Yes, we're so close to finding her now, Frank.
You and Chloe do not know Rachel like I did, and I couldn't even help her. You're in way over your head.
Rachel said she gave you one of her favorite photos. That proves how much she cares. And you care. That's why you have to help.
How the hell did you know about that photo? That's my favorite picture of her. I can look at it anytime and she'll always be there for me. I can't stand not knowing where she is. Not hearing her voice or her laugh anymore.
We can change all that. It's up to you.
Help us find her, Frank. Please. We really need your client list.
Well, if there's a chance in hell, you two dorks can find Rachel. Yeah, I'll take it. My dog isn't barking at you, so I guess that's a good sign.
Thank you.
Yeah, thanks, Frank.
Seriously.
It's hard to take you characters seriously, but I want to. Good luck.
Chloe, are you okay?
I'm glad things worked out okay with Frank. It's nice to have one less enemy in Arcadia Bay.
Amen to that. I better focus on this board and start tying these clues together.
Who's our buddy now? Cool.
Hey Max, see if you can put together all those Rubik's clues. Just holla if you need any info while I go online to make sure we haven't missed anything.
We've printed everything we need. Now it's time to focus on the big board.
Okay, so now it's starting to seem like Phoenix Wright stuff going on.
Let's look at Frank's drug deals during the week of the party.
Okay.
Frank's account book. But the client names are encrypted.
But I have the key.
Frank is for sure the local dealer, but I doubt Rachel was carrying drugs for him. Right? Maybe Rachel took a road trip with Frank, but she did come back. So, what happened to Rachel after this? She dumped Frank, but I don't think he would hurt her. So weird how close they were. But Frank couldn't keep Rachel. Or protect her. Rot must stand for Rottweiler. That does fit Nathan. Rotten. There's no doubt she loved him and some way. Yes! The game is on. Now, talk to us, account book. Tell us everything. Let's see if I can find any deal Frank made with Nathan or the Vortex Club. Frank sure is keeping his customers satisfied. He could open a store.
This one. Rot was okay. Rot, that's Nathan. He bought GHB. What else? Okay.
Everybody in Arcadia Bay must be high. That explains a lot. If Frank applied this kind of detail to his life, who am I to talk? I wonder what dog name Frank would have given me.
And roofies.
I'm getting a contact high just reading this.
Speedballs. Here we go.
Two deals with Nathan on the same day? Yeah. Party supplies, no doubt. Oh, yes. These are all the times and places for Frank and Nathan's deals. That's it, Max.
Max, I know we can snap all these pieces together.
Roger that. I'm gonna study the board and try to connect all these dots.
David's clues.
Thanks to David's own investigation, I should be able to find out what Nathan did during the party's week.
Okay, so I already know that this one was the GPS coordinates.
Right. I hope in this case that David has good tracking skills.
And then the license plate.
Look at all these license plates.
Who was...
I hope he was tailing Nathan. At least David was finally going after the right suspect.
Wait, was there a GPS thing that... No.
David really has been on Rachel's ass for a while. She should have been upset. Of course, I'm a suspect. Proving David sucks as a detective. Does David know what's going on with Rachel, or is he just paranoid about everybody?
Oh, wait, who's... What dates are on this? 7th. Okay.
David should have done way more than take photos of Kate. Maybe he was trying to help Kate in his own messed up way. You need to get rid of these damn cameras, David.
Is that on the head, the license plate is visible?
Okay, this is just sad, Max.
Or maybe it's a different clue right now. Maybe we can focus on a different thing. So, Kate in the parking lot. At 317.
Looks like David was tracking somebody's car.
Right.
Maybe even Nathan's. Good clue. And that's all she wrote. Please let me find some clues about Nathan in here. Great. Now, how do I find out which car is Nathan's to match the coordinates?
Well, it's just like the thing.
Yep, another car David was tracking.
Twin Peaks.
Who else was David tracking here?
Six feet under.
Why the hell are you following these people?
Twilight Zone.
And to where? Of course Nathan drives an SUV. That's definitely Chloe's car.
Just dragging Chloe. Right. Is that Twin Peaks? Chloe. Chloe.
There's Nathan dealing to the kids right out in the open. I'm glad Warren got his revenge. Who does this car belong to? Wow, sir. This looks like an interesting... Is this Nathan's car? Max, there's no logical link between those clues.
Okay, well look, this one. Twin Peaks. Twin Peaks.
Come on. No. Deduce Nathan's license plate number, then match it up with the coordinates. Right. No. This is not working.
Oh, I see. I'm trying to find Nathan's, specifically. Okay. So we know that Nathan's is the one that's like... Twilight Zone, right? Well, they're specifically looking for Nathan's right now.
Damn. Okay. Nathan's taillight is busted.
Right.
And I'm pretty sure I saw that on one of the license plate photos. Oh, you're treading water, Otter.
Try again. This makes no sense, Max.
Did I pick the wrong one? Okay, yeah, I did pick the wrong one. This one.
Okay, Nathan's taillight is busted.
Wait.
And I'm pretty sure I saw that on one of the license plates. Oh, yes.
There we go.
Now we're finally getting somewhere. Chloe, let's plug in these numbers and see if they lead to an actual address.
Aye, aye, Captain. Here we come, Rachel.
Nice. Find out. And the location.
I have to analyze Nathan's messages. What could help me unlock this phone? Couldn't hurt to give this pin code a whack. Holy shit. Nathan is seriously unhinged. But those numbers might be useful. If there is a dark room, we better find it. There's a lot of numbers in here.
What phone number is that?
Okay, Max. Let's blow this code up and go home. Let's start hacking.
Let's try the base.
Oops. Bad code.
Did you never change it?
Yeah, I knew it wouldn't be that easy. You locked it, dumbass. Bad code. Yeah, I knew it wouldn't be that easy. You locked it, dumbass. Bad code. Yeah, I knew it wouldn't be that easy.
So I exhausted the numbers in that. Let's go back to the sheet then.
Oops. Bad code. Yeah, I knew it wouldn't be that easy. You locked it, dumbass.
Oops. Let's Is it red 552 on there? Chloe?
Hey Max, see if you can put together all those Rubik's clues.
Well, he's pissed.
Just holla if you need any info while I go online to make sure we haven't missed anything.
We've printed everything we need. Now it's time to focus on the big board.
So then everything I need is on the board, so it's gotta be present.
Here. Let's start hacking. Oops. Bad code.
Is this upside down?
Yeah, I knew it wouldn't be that easy. You locked it, dumbass.
I'm gonna assume it's obvious.
Bad code.
Maybe it's 8500.
Yeah, I knew it wouldn't be that easy.
The 552 is bugging me though. Why is Rachel's name on there?
You locked it, dumbass.
Wait, what the hell? What am I missing about this paper? Chloe, help me out.
Chloe's on a roll to find more clues about Rachel now that we're so close.
Hey Max, see if you can put together all those Rubik's clues. Just holla if you need any info while I go online to make sure we haven't missed anything.
We've printed everything we need. Now it's time to focus on the big board.
Oh wait, 5 equals 2?
Supplies are endless in
9232.
By the morning they'll be gone.
Oops, bad code.
When everything is lonely, I can be my own best friend. I get a coffee and the paper, have my own conversation. sidewalk and the pigeons and my window reflection.
They're fours.
The mask I polish in the evening by the morning looks like shit. And I know you have.
Yeah, I knew it wouldn't be that easy. Oops, bad code.
Did it do some kind of addition? Why are there two phone numbers up here? There's so many phone numbers, I mean. So clearly he changed it. 0542?
Yeah, I knew it wouldn't be that easy.
Date? Well, his birth date. August, okay, it says we have a 4-digit number. Oh shit, wait. What if it's columns? 0945.
You locked it, dumbass.
Okay, let's try to look.
Oops. Bad code.
Is it columns? 0544.
Oops. Bad code.
Five, three, three, three.
Yeah, I knew it wouldn't be that easy.
8561.
You locked it, dumbass.
Oh man, I suck at number puzzles. This is really fucking hard.
Oops. Bad code. Yeah, I knew it wouldn't be that easy.
Was his birthday? 0829. What up? Need the G. Okay, cool. Bet you still in water, asshole. Then when do we bring in silly pigs on the beach?
Yes. This is all about Nathan trying to score for the Vortex Club party. Nathan was jonesing hard the night of the party. He didn't have enough drugs. Drug dealer drama.
Night prices.
God, Nathan. You're out of control. So it was you.
Now I can officially call you a psycho stalker. No, Nathan, it's time for you to watch out. Asshole.
Is this from Nathan's father? That's brutal.
Take a breath, Max.
Okay.
Go through all this data and you can find out where Nathan took Kate. So, this infamous party was the 4th.
4th at 8 p.m. Is there anything that places it there? Okay, so it's 7th, 7th, 4th. This is during the party. Okay. Yeah, this is that.
That beach is like Frank's main office. Was Frank meeting Nathan at the junkyard? I know Nathan wasn't looking for Bigfoot in the forest. Somebody is stocking up on gas.
Why? Where he's on the way there.
No doubt that Nathan stays in his dorm room. So, he could be hiding clues there too.
So wasn't it at school?
Not much out there.
This barn.
Chloe, this is definitely the place.
Let me dig up some more clothes here. Nope. Nothing, Max. There's nothing here. Just some shitty old barn.
Let's keep searching and find out who owns this haunted barn.
I'm on this. Hold on.
Prescott's.
Somebody named Harry Aaron Prescott.
I'm shocked. Should we call the police?
Fuck that. You know the police here are like Nathan's private security, right?
That's so messed up.
As you've noticed, this whole town is messed up. We can't trust anybody except each other. So we have to go out to that farmhouse by ourselves.
I was afraid you'd say that. We could call Warren since he kicked Nathan's ass.
It's just the two of us, nobody else. And I'm not scared at all. You have the power. I feel like we're this close to finding Rachel. We have to find her, Max.
We will. But remember, my power isn't infinite. We still have to be careful. Do you hear, Chloe?
Yes, sir. I know, but we're here. Let's go find the best way in.
I mean, there's holes all over the damn building.
Whoa, check this out. Fresh tire tracks.
Nathan was here.
Dude, somebody was just here.
Then we need to get in that barn.
Yeah, I didn't have a chance to get into the girls' dorm yet.
Chloe, I found the front door. Come on.
Oh, yes. Maximus rules.
God, this is way too Blair Witch. I have goosebumps all over.
Come on, Supermax. Hey, check out this old chest.
A little louder, Chloe. Jeez, that is ancient.
Jackpot. Old shit.
No. Look closer.
Harry Aaron Prescott and family donate new library to Arcadia Bay. Prescott Industries celebrate grand opening.
The grandfather.
Prescott's bring bomb shelter boom to town.
Nice scrapbook. You search for more clues and I'll scope out the area. Chloe would make a great detective too. Even Harry Aaron Prescott was into selfies.
Bomb shelter, quite possibly, I believe it.
This tractor has paid its dues. I guess the Prescotts were just born bastards.
Lots of info here.
Wow, sir. Talk about home on the range.
Kindness for kindness.
There's no way this rusty-ass button will activate these ropes or pulleys.
Make your life hell. Best regards.
If a zombie shows up, I have my weapon. Huh. These hooks are used to lift haystacks. I saw them in a Friday the 13th movie. Ah, the good old days.
Cocaine.
So many haystacks, so few needles. So many haystacks, so few needles.
Panel?
Nothing here.
Oh.
Scope out the perimeter, Max.
Oh, God, no.
There has to be more here than
this crate. What is this? It's totally brand new. Why? No, Supermax. You can't open this with your bare hands.
Drop something on it.
Okay, Chloe. I found some kind of hatch, but it's locked. I got this. I hope. There's no way this rusty-ass button will activate these ropes or pulleys. Chloe, can you give me a hand?
Sidekick at your service. Hop, hop, and away, Supermax.
I dig having minions.
Gotta grab on and just jump with that rope. Or put a haystack on it.
Nope.
That's not gonna be enough weight.
I can't pull this rope without tearing my flesh off. I need to hook this up to something heavier.
Oh, I know. I'll go up and rewind.
MacGyver strikes again.
What the fuck is down there? Fucking like torture room.
Damn, this is heavy. What is this? Jackpot. Do I even need to say how weird this is?
This is a Capcom game. This is what
they just did.
Map is.
Who built this kind of place?
A Prescott, of course.
Maybe it is a bomb shelter.
This bunker is so surreal.
In the movies.
Open sesame.
The only 3-digit number.
Stocked and ready for the apocalypse. This must have cost a fortune. Come on.
Now I have a safe place for the tornado. Oh man, imagine if I didn't unlock this.
What the hell is this? Water supplies. It's like in David's garage bunker. More survivalist supplies. Look at these cans. David must shop at the same store. Whoa. This says it all about Nathan. He needs help.
What's the dance floor?
Duct tape in a bunker is always a bad sign.
Oh, that is. Oh, what the fuck? Oh my god. Nathan, what the fuck?
I guess Nathan needs the most expensive printer in the world. That son of a bitch.
$1 million.
Talk about tortured.
Literally?
Everything is sketchy as fuck, but nothing about Rachel here.
Whoa. What is going on between Nathan and his father?
Is the dad a time traveler too?
Let's see what's in here. Oh my god. No.
The white room. It was Nathan. done this to every girl at the school?
Come on, let's see what this shit is all about.
We are. Okay, a binder marked Victoria, but it's empty.
Look, the next one says Kate.
Victoria's no, next. Kate. No.
God, I should have killed that bastard back there.
Kate wasn't the first. All those binders are filled with other victims. Victoria has to be next. Nathan must be planning to dose her tonight at the Vortex Club party.
Rachel. This can't be real. These are all post shots, right? Right?
Chloe, look at her face. She's out of it.
Maybe Nathan paid her a shitload of cash to do this. She probably would have.
I don't think so. Why is he putting her in the ground like that? Where?
The junkyard. Max, we have to find that spot now. Then we can see what he did. There's no way she's dead. No way. She posed for those pictures, Max. I know it. Please, let's go.
Oh my god. Rachel. Kate looks so doped up. She has no idea she's being posed. At least Kate was asleep through all this bullshit. This picture is framed different. Rachel is awake and fucking furious. Rachel is passed out and she has something in her mouth. What happened to her? This shot is so staged. I can't believe it's real. I can't.
Unbelievable. Under-fucking-leavable. This is fucking ridiculous.
Ah, the Apocalypse Entertainment System. I've never seen so much pricey equipment before. So who's using this fancy tripod?
What the fuck did he submit for the contest?
These newspapers are all about Rachel and Kate. Somebody likes their whiskey.
Chloe, is she okay? She went up ahead.
Oh.
Victoria, no.
I hope Nathan enjoys his last party. Chloe, we can go right to the cops. We have proof. Fuck the police. Rachel wanted us to find her, so we could get real justice and revenge. The Prescotts have had this coming for 100 years, and nobody is gonna get in my way. Especially with your help, right?
I'm with you to the end, Chloe. You know that.
You're right. Look at the outline.
I can't tell if they're different.
What is
there
that?
Can't be two moons.
Jesus, Chloe, look up at the sky.
Possible.
Beautiful. I don't give a shit. The world is ending. Cool.
You're not listening. Something major is going down.
That's right. Nathan Prescott is going down.
That is not supposed to happen.
Welcome to the end of the world, ladies. I'm glad you decided to escort me.
You look really good, Warren. Are you all right after today?
I really flipped out on Nathan. I just hate bullies. And Max, he's dangerous.
Where is he?
I didn't see him at the dorm again. I was held up in my room.
Dude,
have you been drinking?
Well, if you consider half a beer drinking.
Let's go, Max.
Hey, hey. I know this is a bad time, but can I get one picture? I've been feeling like this might be actually the end of the world,
yes,
so...
because I can go
I
back.
I want to have something for prosperity.
Well, I don't blame you, Warren.
A reset.
I know. I'm a pain in the booty. Just one picture.
Action.
We've got no time for this shit. Come on, Max.
Sorry. I just wanted to feel like a normal student after this week's ultra-violence. I never hit anybody like that before. I was always the one getting my ass kicked.
Hey, we still need your expert help. If you see Nathan, text me immediately, okay? And do not let him see you.
He won't. I know how to be invisible here.
Not to me, Warren. Text soon.
Hi, can I take your coat or anything? No, I didn't see any tablet with cat pics.
Okay, Chloe, where the hell are you?
All these clothes.
It is kind of nasty.
Plus, some of the Vortex Club always give me attitude.
Stella, that's...
Hi, Stella.
Hey, Max. Welcome to the end of the world. Do you want me to check anything in?
No thanks, Stella. Have you seen Nathan yet?
No, thank God. That boy creeps me out. Wait, some girl just asked about Nathan before you came in.
What girl?
She had blue hair, dressed like a punk. I've seen her putting up those Rachel Amber posters. I'm stuck here, so I'm sorry I can't help you.
So why are you working at a Vortex Club party? I didn't think you wanted to be a member.
Screw that. I'm here for the job.
Who hired you?
Mr. Jefferson asked me because he knows I don't have a lot of money, even with my job and scholarship. I'm not cool enough for this school.
Yes, you are, Stella. You're smart, honest, and you bust your ass for Blackwell. I hope everything turns out your way in the end.
Well, thank you, Max. I really appreciate that. Hey, your face looks so intense. Are you okay?
No, I'm actually not okay. I just need to find Nathan. And don't get too close if you see him.
Hell no. This is homework, not a party. I'll text you if I spy him. Good luck.
Nice. Eyes all over this place.
Just to see him flirt with Brooke. Are Daniel and Brooke flirting? Right on.
Hi, Daniel.
Yes! Max makes an entrance! I only came to the party because of you.
I'm glad to see you out and about. By the way, have you seen Nathan Prescott tonight?
No, I've been hanging with Brooke since I got here. Max, are you okay? Your face looks so serious.
I know. I'm not in party mode tonight.
You look like you have a secret mission.
This is where it's going to end. For Rachel's sake.
Well, if you want to hang out with Brooke and me, we're here for you.
Thanks, Daniel. I have to stay on my mission now. I hope you stay on yours and become a great artist.
Well, I'll be celebrating someday in a museum next. Adios.
Hello, Brooke.
Max, I didn't expect to see you at a Vortex Club party.
I didn't expect that either, but I really need to find Nathan. Have you?
No, I haven't seen him. And I'm not looking for him, so I most likely won't tonight. I just hate that scrub and his club.
So why are you here tonight?
No homework? Boredom? Waiting?
Have you seen Warren tonight?
No, but we're going to map out our drive-in date later. I was just talking to Daniel about a road trip next week to the Portland Art Museum.
Oh, that is so cool. He needs a friend. I bet Daniel will be a great museum guide.
I'm more into science than art, but what kind of a selfish fangirl would miss a Miyazaki exhibition?
You're not selfish, Brooke. You're just trying to live your life without all this bullshit. Like all of us here.
You seem so wise. Kind of invincible this week. I think that snow and eclipse gave you superpowers. Check to see if you can fly.
Only with your drone. By the way, did you see that crazy double moon out there earlier?
Max, if I saw a double moon out there, I would assume it really was the end of the world.
Well, the night is still young, Brooke.
And so are we, Max. So let's plan a drone date next week.
No one seems to know where Nathan is. Is he hiding? Energy drinks, soda, energy drinks. I know somebody has the news. There's Courtney drinking alone, without Taylor or Victoria. I wonder why.
I just wish someone would kick Nathan's ass.
Max, you're the only person I don't mind seeing right now.
I was looking for Nathan.
I've avoided almost everybody here tonight. Why are you looking for Nathan?
I want to make sure he's not gonna do anything tonight.
Like what happened to Kate. Oh wait, I did see Nathan today, nursing a busted face. I had dreams that somebody finally kicked his ass.
Well, Luke, sometimes dreams come true. Warren gave him an epic beatdown.
Yes! Give it up for Brother Warren. Now all we have to do is drive all these goddamn Prescott vampires out of town.
I think Sean Prescott wants to drive all of us out of town. Or into Pan Estates.
I met him once at a Bigfoots game. Mean fucking bastard. Oh man, he explains Nathan.
Preach it, Brother Luke. Okay, I have to get going. Thanks for seeing me.
No, thank you. And for helping Kate. And for keeping it real. Peace out.
Bigfoot on Otter action. Of the Vortex Club. What would a shitty party be without glow sticks? Apparently, Blackwell has a severe toilet paper fetish.
I can drink more later.
Just a photo.
I'm not in the mood, but still, this could be an interesting shot.
Yo, Maximum Overdrive, about time you got here to save this lame rave. Wanna get ripped?
You look pretty ripped already, Justin. And not happy. Why did you even come tonight?
Where else could I go in Arcadia Bay on a Thursday night? Besides, Dana is here. She's not with me. So yes, this party sucks.
Speaking of, have you seen Nathan?
Oh, he should be freaking out in the VIP lounge with that whore text club. Fucking hate those snobby douchebags. Especially Nathan. That dude is gonna go on a rampage soon.
You might be right, so stay away from him tonight, okay? Spread the word.
Max, I know I'm twisted, but your face looks so fucking intense. And your voice sounds different. You okay? How about a quick dab?
No, I'm cool, Justin.
and I have to get going. Maybe you should go chill somewhere else.
Fucking A, Maximus. You're right. I'm only torturing myself here. Plus, I'm too loaded. It's time to get my board and grind.
The tide is turning. I'd like to tear every one of these things down. Ugh, gross. How did this even get here? Good night, sweet prince.
You've been vomiting for like an hour.
Somebody's either having sex or throwing up. Or both. Ugh, Max. Chloe must be around.
Super Max lives.
Not anymore.
I edited the dragons.
Yes, you do suck. Trust me, dude. You're not missing anything. I'm so not impressed by this VIP crap.
Excuse me, but I'm going in.
Sorry, but this is the VIP section. Members only. Okay?
Sorry, but I'm on the list. Okay?
I know that Max Caulfield is not on any list for the Vortex Club. Nice try.
Listen!
No, you listen. Courtney is supposed to be the VIP gatekeeper, not me. So please go.
I need to find a way to enter this bullshit club.
Courtney, how are you?
Max, our guest star arrives fashionably late. Say bonsoir to the end of the world. Even though you flaked on my party makeover, you still get special access to the Vortex Club VIP lounge.
You better let your minion know, since she won't let me pass.
Oh, that little asshole just made her last mistake. She thinks she's Victoria. Bye-bye. Now, let's go make an official VIP entrance, Max Factor. Get it?
Good.
Hey, Sarah, do you know that I personally put Max's name on the list? So, you, like, decide to block her from coming in while I'm taking a break? You're not in charge here.
Wait, I just...
Oh my god, you're done! And you're off the list permanently. Welcome to the Vortex Club.
Less people here because I added it.
Nathan is the Vortex Club. So his ass has to be here tonight.
This is bad. It's giving me the farewell to everybody.
She's wasted, and nobody is looking out for her. Nobody learns at Blackwell.
Is it me?
Or surprise, Hayden is trashed.
What's up, Hayden?
Look. Up in the sky, it's Super Max here to save the party.
Have you seen Nathan?
I just vaped some dank OG buds, so I can barely see you. Or are these hotties next to me? You want a hit?
No. I want to find Nathan.
Me too! He's supposed to be bringing some special party favors. I hope that the party you actually planned a party at the party.
Not this week. So, has anybody here seen Nathan?
I guess you have to go ask everybody here. Or you can sit down and take a quick nap.
What about Victoria?
Yeah, go ask her yourself. I would, but like I said, I'm fucking ripped.
Maybe you better take it easy tonight.
Whatever. I'm in this world to have fun. try it sometime, Max. I finally get you and Dana to come out to a Vortex Club party, but you just want to lecture me? Gee, thanks, Mr. Madsen.
How much fun did Kate have at your last party? Listen, honey. Just watch out for Nathan tonight.
I think that's your job, Max. Come back when you're ready to come.
A bomb. Give me a break.
Have you seen Nathan yet?
No, that's fine by me. He's been getting, like, too buggy and kind of scary. Victoria might know.
What does Victoria say about them?
She blows it off, but Vic is close with Nathan. They're more like brother-sister. Or something. She really cares about him.
Is this why you want to be in a Vortex Club?
No, Max. I'm, like, far from home at a great school. I want to learn things, make friends, and party. But when Kate was on the roof, I knew I'd gone too far.
Kate was dosed at the last Vortex Club party by Nathan. So you should avoid any drink here tonight.
Trust me, I won't even drink my own water when Nathan is around now. He's a pharmacy simulator.
I do have to go now. Look out for yourself, Taylor. And give my best to your mom.
Oh, thanks, Max. She's doing great after her surgery. I'm glad to know you're looking out for us, too.
So the Vortex VIPs get real alcohol at their underage bar. Chips and crackers. Spare no expense, Vortex Club. I know Victoria is next on Nathan's hit list. Should I warn her?
Did you hear something?
Can I talk to you for a second?
No.
I get it.
Have
real
you seen
fucking
Nathan?
Nice. I can't even get Victoria or Taylor to twerk. And you want to hang with Nathan? Why?
Business.
You should talk to his dad then. Bro has got more money than God, and he spends it on the Vortex Club, not the losers over there in the cheap seats.
Logan, this is a swimming pool. In other words, you haven't seen Nathan.
Ask Victoria. She always knows where he is. Why don't you ever want to see him, Max? You're so cute, and we never really talk.
Talk about what?
The next Bigfoots game. We could go out to the field. I could show you some moves. Get you a touchdown.
Logan, don't make me hurt.
Damn. That was way more exciting than a dance. Catch you later, Max.
Sorry, Max. Vortex Club members only.
Sorry. I'm on the guest list.
I'm taking you off.
Go fuck yourself, Victoria. I don't have time for this bullshit.
Real cute, Max. You still pissed about me taking your picture?
Do you even have a clue what's going on at Blackwell? Kate Marsh tried to kill herself in front of you. And me. Everybody here.
That's not my fault, Max. Don't you even try to blame me.
I don't blame you, Victoria, but you know Kate had a church group and that she didn't party. So why did you send out that video?
Oh, God. I swear we weren't even going to do it. Then we had some wine and got stupid.
More than stupid, it's mean, hateful. Kate never did anything to you. And that didn't stop me from taking one last video of her on the group.
I deleted that from my phone. Maybe I'm not her friend, but I didn't get off on Kate attempting suicide. I'm not evil, Max.
I believe you, Victoria. But I don't understand you.
That makes both of us, Max. I always feel like I have to overcompensate. For what, I have no clue. I'm only here to become a photographer, not president.
You have talent, Victoria. You don't have to push people out of your way.
You don't understand. My parents own a gallery. I know how this art game has to be played. It's brutal.
No, it's art. You don't have to play their way. Mr. Jefferson doesn't talk that way, and he's famous.
Yeah, Mr. Jefferson probably won't be choosing my photo. I'm not as talented as I thought.
Yes, you are. But we shouldn't have to choose between talent and kindness.
I hope. Hard to believe, but I don't always make the best choices. Do you think it's like fate we're not supposed to be friends?
Maybe, but who says we have to be enemies?
Whoever makes that decision.
That would be us, Victoria.
Well, Max Caulfield, I could always choose to let you in the Vortex Club.
I don't think that's gonna happen. But not for the reasons you think.
Oh, you look so serious.
Victoria, enough of this high school bullshit. We're adults now. Listen to me. Your life is in serious danger. I know you're close to Nathan, but he is truly unstable and dangerous. He did drug Kate at that party so he could take her someplace. Dark.
Oh my god. And I'm the drama queen?
Touché. But I am not fucking around.
Sorry, but no. No way. Nathan is like one of my best friends. Yes, he takes serious meds, but that's not his fault. His family treats him like a total freak just because he has little meltdowns.
They're not little anymore. They're deadly. I don't care if you hate me or not. You have to believe me.
I don't believe anything you say. You're full of shit. Oh, hi, I'm Max Caulfield, and I'm so sensitive that butterflies make me cry.
Now, will you?
No, I won't. You're just pissed because you didn't enter a photo in the contest and that Mr. Jefferson is going to pick me. A real artist would have busted ass to win, but you just want to take your little retro selfies. That is so fucking lame and lazy, Max. Just go find a community college.
Victoria, please don't do this. Especially after what happened with Kate. Can't you see I'm serious?
That's your problem, Max. This is a party, and it's the end of the world, so I am going to get so wasted, even you won't bother me anymore. I'll let Nathan know if he finally shows up. Adios.
Au revoir.
Okay, I tried. She's not gonna believe me over her Vortex Club partner.
Yay, Max! I can't believe you showed up. Why didn't you tell me? We could have dressed up together.
As you can tell by my outfit, I was in a hurry. Dana, have you seen Nathan around?
Hell no, I've been dancing with Trevor. Come on and dance with us. Look at Trevor trying to bust a move.
How's the end of the world going?
Great! This has been the worst fucking week of my life, so I needed to act like a carefree student tonight. For Kate.
I hear you, Dana. But I want you to avoid Nathan if you see him, okay?
I will if I want to have fun. I still feel sorry for him. He needs help, but not from his family.
The Vortex Club is also enabling him.
I know. Juliet wrote a story describing it like a cult, and I'm starting to think she was right. It's not fun anymore.
Sounds like you're ready for a change.
I don't need any club to be cool or have friends. Look at you. Plus, I like hanging with Trevor and his skater friends. No drama.
That sounds like a plan, Dana. I'm glad Trevor is with you tonight.
Thanks. The boy cannot dance, though. Look at that.
That son of a bitch is not here. Where are you, Nathan? I better get Chloe. Oh, that makes me want to pull a Carrie on the Vortex Club. Oxygen kit might come in handy if somebody binges. Oh, good. Chloe's here.
There you are. Chloe, Nathan isn't here. Nobody has seen him tonight.
He's definitely not upstairs or in the lockers.
Damn. Maybe he's hiding in his dorm.
Then let's bail. Nathan can't hide anymore.
So, you made it, Vince.
Oh, hey, Mr. Jefferson.
Are you both okay? You look like you're on a mission.
Oh, I was just looking for Nathan.
Uh-huh. But I didn't know you were pals with him. I haven't seen him since this afternoon. He seemed pretty upset. I think he's still quite upset over the whole Kate situation.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Let's talk later, Max. I have to announce the winner of the contest. I do wish you would have entered. You have to build up that resume and portfolio, but I know you will.
Thanks. I hope so.
Okay, excuse me. I'm almost on.
Let's get the hell out of here, Max.
Okay, everybody calm down. Thank you. I appreciate it. But I don't want to get in the way of the party, but it's time to announce the winner of the Everyday Heroes Contest. Before I do, I want to thank everybody who entered their photograph and everybody who thought about entering. Now, this is the most important step in being an artist, sharing your work with the world. All of you represent Blackwell Academy and everything our school stands for. As far as I'm concerned, you're all everyday heroes. The envelope, please. And the winner is...
Come on!
Oh my, what a shocker. Victoria Chase.
Mr. Jefferson, it was your incredible photography that brought me to Blackwell, and I hope I can live up to your name and fame. I also want to thank all the students for being so dedicated in their pursuit. And I'd like to dedicate this prize to Kate Marsh. She is the real everyday hero of Blackwell, and I can't wait for her to come back. Thank you.
You suck, Victoria!
Victoria won. Big surprise. I can't believe she blackmailed Jefferson. Well, yes, I can. Who fucking cares? Rachel is still dead, and I want Nathan's punk ass now. Me too. Let's go check out the dormitories. Nathan just texted me. He says there won't be any evidence left after he's done. Shit. We have to go to the junkyard right now. Around, Chloe.
Right. Just get ready to use your rewind fast if Nathan tries to jump us. Rewind so I can kill him over and over.
Jesus, be quiet, okay? We have to be invisible.
God, I want to fucking kill that little psycho.
Hey, I can't focus if you're yelling.
Max, please
hurry.
Oh God, Max, look. She's still there.
Don't look, Chloe. Oh, no. Chloe, look out.
What the fuck?
Oh, shit.
Chloe.
If I still have the photo from the beginning of the party, I should be able to butterfly it. Maybe he was brought in as a potential mentor for Nathan, but instead of helping him, he enabled him. And maybe the whole plan was to take Victoria on the contest all along so he could do the final album. A long episode. Yeah, of course Victoria didn't believe me. I was like her enemy for the entire game. I remember David's code. Wow, only 28% figured out Nathan's pin. That would have changed like everything. Oh, the weather gets progressively worse. More episodes you complete. It's nuts. Okay. Well, that's that. One more episode. what made me think it was Jefferson? It's possible he got there before, if he has a version of Rewind. I refuse to subscribe to the she's the only one with that power theory. And if he's advanced the power far enough beyond where Max has, then that would explain his interest in collecting photographs. The reason why I thought it was him is because all of the other characters had pretty clear, personalities imprinted on them, but Jefferson was the one with the most blank personality, right? That everyone, you know, like, the blanks are being filled in very slowly, so it was like, you know what, it would be really easy to pull that twist without having to explain away a bunch of stuff. Like, for example, let's presume that it was David Madsen all along, then they'd have to do a whole bunch of explaining why, oh, well, you see, the whole thing about him being concerned, the father was actually a front, blah, 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 blah. The principal, it's like, you know, oh, he wasn't just an alcoholic, he was actually, it was a cover story, and he was just in on it all along with Nathan Prescott. But Jefferson was so blank that it was just really easy for him to pull a light about me. Man, one more episode. It's definitely a thing. Victoria's probably gonna die now. Because she didn't believe me. Because he fucked around with her the entire time.